So hello students, welcome to this session. So in today's session we'll be discussing regarding the difference between the community medicine versus clinical medicine. So before getting to the various aspects what we are seeing in the medical level, so one has to be aware the different types of medicine what we are facing, what we are getting exposed in the day-to-day life. So the main difference between the community medicine as well as clinical medicine, community, as it indicates, the name indicates, it is concentrating on the complete set of people or the population where a group of people are staying. So in case of any disease which are pretend to be arise in that specific community or in that specific society, so the certain care precautions as well as the required aspects, the clinical aspects, the diagnostic aspects, as well as the management aspects will be taken care as a set of people by concentrating on the group of people. That is nothing but the community medicine. Whereas in clinical medicine, if a patient or an individual is getting consulted with the physician individually or individually for any certain elements with the certain specific signs and symptoms, where the physician will be prescribing the medicine for that specific illness or the disease, is nothing but the clinical medicine. So in small aspects, what you can say is community medicine plans and implements over the group of people in the community, whereas clinical medicine will be focusing on the individual patient. So before getting into the community medicine, the difference between the community medicine as well as the clinical medicine, so first we'll see regarding the definition of medicine. So medicine is, which is nothing but it is a branch of science which is concerned with prevention of disease and maintenance of good health, diagnosis of disease and treatment. So there are certain things, whereas nutritional related disorders, in case of any deficiency, so we'll call it as deficiency disorders. So in case of that, where the medicine will be given to prevent certain diseases, suppose vitamin D supplements will be given, vitamin B complex supplements will be given in bone deformity. So in any case of pains, so if there is the deficiency of vitamin D or B complex vitamins, so that is the prevention of disease and maintenance of good health. So to avoid the further complication or controversies, or to avoid the morbidity or mortality rate in the public, so for the maintenance of good health, the medicines will be given. Diagnosis of diseases and treatments, as you all are aware, the medicine, certain medicines will be used as a diagnostic aspect also, as well as for the treating of the patients. So mainly the medicine is having of two branches. First is preventive and curative. So preventive is nothing but before getting the disease to this patient, so the prevention of specific disease. So mainly what we are seeing is the certain medicines before getting to the vaccines, especially vaccines. So before getting or to avoid poliomyelitis, so other diseases, to avoid specific diseases, so the vaccines will be given in the earlier stages of life, where to prevent specific disease. That is preventive medicine. Whereas curative medicine is nothing but if a patient comes with a complaint of cold, flu, headache, or any other diseased ailments, so that accordingly the medicine will be given. So that is nothing but the curative. So mainly the medicine is of two branches. First one is preventive and second one will be curative. If we see the difference between the community medicine and clinical medicine, so the objective of the community medicine is to prevent the disease. Before getting into the community, what are the steps, what are the measures to be taken to prevent the disease? So that is the main objective of the community medicine. Whereas clinical medicine, the objective is once the patient comes to the physician with specified complaints or issues or with the signs and symptoms to cure the disease. So that is the objective of the clinical medicine. Whereas if you see in the community medicine, as I said before, it concentrates on the entire community or a group of people to eradicate that specific diseases and to maintain the healthy in to maintain the community in the healthiest aspect, the community medicine works. Whereas in clinical medicine, where they will be focusing only diseased patients, or where they will be having only on the disease, individual patients will be concentrated, cared, and the treatment will be given through the clinical medicine. So mainly, in coming to the tools and diagnosis, what we see in the community medicine is regarding the epidemiological and statistical studies. So where the birth morbidity and mortality rate cases, where the number of population is there in the community, and the number of patients affected in the community. So depending upon all these things, a proper graphical presentation will be made to eradicate that specific disease. Whereas coming to the tools of diagnosis in the clinical medicine, well, they will be taking the detailed history of the patient, clinical examination will be done, and the respective investigations will be made to rule out the proper diagnosis of the patient. And coming to the management, so management is a very important aspect in the community medicine. So community medicine, how they will manage the disease, or how they are going to prevent the disease, is by conveying the patients regarding the healthy diet, physical activities, nutritional status, regarding the hygiene of the water, disposal of waste, proper dressing, and keeping oneself in the hygienic aspects. So these are the criterias where the community will be educated in the form of seminars, COEs, workshops, or any other aspects in the public domain for the upliftment of community by educating the people with respect to all sorts of urban as well as rural related people, where educating the patients regarding the disease aspects and how they can overcome, and how they are going to manage in the clinical medicine is through the medicine or the surgical. So in the initial stages, where the medicines will be prescribed, once if it doesn't comes under control in the with the medicine, then they have to go with the surgical intervention to avoid the morbidity as well as the mortality. And come next aspect is regarding the evaluation, assessment of health programs and health status of community by calculation of rates. As I said before, how we are doing is regarding today a new disease has been arisen in the community. So after 1 week, for a set of people, for a set of population of 1,000 population, how many were affected on the day 1, how many are affected on the day 10. So like this, for a regular interval of time, the proper statistics, the proper graphical presentations will be made, and how many mortality, morbidity rates will take place with respect to that specific disease. Depending upon this, the incidence and the evaluation will be done through the community medicine. Whereas in the clinical medicine, where the follow-up of the patients after the medical intervention or the surgical intervention, the patient is asked to do the follow-up where they have to come and they have to convey regarding the pros and cons, what are the side effects, what they are feeling, as well as if they have any other added health issues or if they are comfortable. So the reviews, the follow-ups are made every 15 days to 1 month, depending upon the condition of the patient. And coming to the branches of community medicine, mainly it deals with epidemiological studies, statistics, nutrition, health services, and management. Whereas in the branches, what we see in the clinical medicine is regarding the pediatrics, gynecology, cardiology, general surgeon, psychiatrist, pulmonologist. So they have around different set of branches. Well, they are specified with that specific systems. So mainly the pulmonologist will be dealing with the respiratory system, and the gynecologist will be dealing with obstetric, and gynecologist will be dealing with genital and pregnant related issues, whereas the gastroenterologist will be dealing with the gastrointestinal tract, and cardiologist will be dealing with the cardiovascular system. So where that specific system will be having specific specialization, well, they will be dealing with that specific disease. Okay, thank you.